Everybody, I'm very surprised that so many people are here, but not really, so we go to special guests. So, I honestly expected something like that. My name is Klaus Bollinger, I'm professor for structural engineering. And we are here today for the final review of our seminar about Yona Friedman's Ville, Spatiale. And this is a very special review today, for we have today the person who gives the name of the seminar as our guest. I welcome our guests, Kristina, Schinegger, welcome from the University of Innsbruck. Zillner and Bogner from the Kiesler and Gerald, I'm so happy that you are here. Gerald, Bast, our president. Thank you. And I say thank you to both of you guys. Yeah, Andrei, Gheorghe, Florian, Medicus. We are the teaching team here. And now I hand over to Florian for the introductions.
Well, welcome to this year's final review of architecture, structural design B, we call it. It is in the Institute of Architecture that we have a series of seminars over the last more than 10 years that we analyze unbuilt projects of the 20th century that we believe are icons and very valuable to the architectural history, but never got built for several reasons. And we started this series with works of the Russian avant-garde, such as Vladimir Tuplin and Elisitsky, Maxim Melnikov. Frederick Kiesler, we did twice, and this resulted in a very beautiful book. And this year's special is an unplanned one, I must say, because when we thought about what to do in summer semester, and we came up with Yona Friedman, it was February, and it was then 2 weeks later that the Kiesler Prize was announced, and so all this happened on a kind of coincidence, which we're very happy to have you both here, and which gives us the opportunity to have this so well presented as we never had it before. The guests were already introduced, there are some more, and Andrei would now, I will say a couple of words on the techniques that we use, on the special intents of these seminars, and we will then have the chance to discuss this further within our discussion.
Thanks. I would just like to share some words on how we, you know, we teach the students. And this class is named Advanced Structural Design, but we deeply think that successful projects are projects which are developed and taught interdisciplinary. We ask the students to work in groups, analyzing hundred projects and using digital techniques, digital technologies, in order to define a structural concept, but also rethink it architecturally and finally develop a new project with a concept derived from architectural and structural concepts using digital technologies. We deeply think that digital technologies very much change the way we, you know, we think and we define architectural design, and we encourage students to really think interdisciplinary. We think we assume that answers of you know, of future projects will be more successful if they're thought interdisciplinary, and this is how we work with the students. I would like the first group now to come up.
One of the first ones that did urban gardening. And Then later on, there was a 2005, there was another garden project in the middle of the Heldenplatz, which kind of set off a spark of our project. So basically, we want to talk about food, and we want to talk about green spaces in urban areas. So approximately by 2050, an estimated 70% of the world population will be living in cities. So basically, we're kind of detached from our, let's say, green roots and green thumbs. Most of the food that we get has to travel at least 2,000 or more kilometers, to reach its final destination. So there is a long way coming and going in terms of transit when it comes to food. So what we're saying, we want to introduce a new system that basically has a very big, large garden structure in the middle of a city. So what are we trying to achieve? So what we're trying to achieve is a local food system that is more interconnected in its surroundings. So it will reach over the districts. It provides space for communal activities, refocusing the city's attention on urban agriculture, introducing forgotten and old crops to the public, a place for communication, education, and so on. So what we're trying to achieve is basically to give back to the communities within the surrounding areas. And then there is this word of urban gardening, but Vienna or Europe has an old history also with Schrebergärten, which is basically like the small community gardens. It's very popular, but it has a, let's say, an olderish connotation to it. So we are trying to change this. We are trying to do like kind of the Schrebergarten 2.0.
Concerning our structural concept, we did also research about space frame, and also we go more in detail and research about the protein structure. And for us, we took out of the research that we want also to create a modular system which is scalable and flexible in its size and scale and can be created at its complexity. So, also a main reference for our further project was the Ville Spatiale and also the space frame of our field. So we started with one bounding box or one bounding frame and tried to stack it together and to reduce its elements and try to change the geometries in more free-form space structure. And also concerning architectural space, we try to inscribe a shell system inside of the bounding. So coming back to our research again, we tried to analyze the space frame structure from the protein structure, which should give us then for our elements hands and possible outcome. So our idea is to let the kind of new space frame structure and the new architecture space in the ground grow from the work garden to the work itself. So we're starting to let a kind of bounding messing growing from the floor up to the work itself. And then we applied again the system from the treatment with the protein structure to see how it will look like and how it can help us for our system.
But basically, going further, we had our structure laid out, but then we had basically no program for it, or not yet. So we had to come up with some kind of system of how spaces could attach to each other. So we have public gardens, huts, private gardens, infrastructure and vertical structures, neutral spaces, which are basically like zones for everyone, and then sanitary spaces that is also for everyone. And so we basically came up with a couple of different agglomerations of these different systems, so we are able to stack them over the whole span of the structure. So this was our second try, which is basically just the first sketch of how big we wanted the whole structure to grow over the whole area. Second one?
Yeah, then we start to split our system in three main parts, so we will have the main circulation, which is based on a seemingly randomly space frame structure, which we explain later how we achieve the structure itself. So we always start in all three parts from a bounding box, which gave us a frame for the size. Then we apply the space frame, and then we analyze it. And all these steps we do for all of our three systems. So this is the first system, the horizontal circulation in our system itself. Then we have intersection points where we combine the two directions. And then we combine it with the vertical course, which is the vertical development from the ground level up to our system itself.
And after we start to define it, you know, we take a piece of the structure and we define the core, the size of the core. The size is 8 meters square. And the distance between the column are 32 meters, and we try to optimize the size of the cross section, and the, also the position, the position of the element inside the core and the yeah, that is the first example. Yeah.
Yeah, then we combine the system, so the horizontal circulation system in the course, and analyze it again, a kind of proof of concept if it will work further if we add also the additional layer, the units, so the architectural urban garden space. So going back, we start again for our units with a bounding box, a frame. We divided in upper and lower beam structure and tried to find the optimum diagonal beam structure. So by a computational evolutionary algorithm, we tried to optimize the connection between the points of the upper and the lower beam. So this is a kind of proof for to show how it works. So we start simple with one unit, which will connect it on to other units, and then we apply a simple load to try if it works, because we will later have a huge space, mega structure, and it's not that easy to prove the concept in itself, so we start always with one type of example, a prototype example. Yeah, then we stack more units together, analyze it again, apply more loads, like wind loads, snow loads, and step weight, and then we try to find out if it works and how we can change the stacking of the units itself. So another image about the atmosphere. Yeah, then to reduce the utilization displacement of the system, we try to optimize also the cross section, which gives later on also for the aesthetic appearance a different appearance of the whole structure itself. So again, a proof of concept if it will work and how it will look like if the cross section are different.
Within this space frame, we wanted to create an architectural space, so we actually needed an enclosure. So we divided the surface of the primitive along these beams, which Leonie was explaining before, and we changed the rotation of this elements according to the sun, because we analyzed the hottest month, the hottest time in Vienna, and we analyzed these openings, which you can see later, so that in the summer the sun doesn't shine directly into this unit. And here you can see how we did this. So we subdivided the surface along these frames, and by orientation of these panelings along the axis, we kind of optimized it so the sun doesn't shine directly into the unit.
Then one prototype or one example of our units. So it's divided in its main structure. So the space frame, and then we applied some sandwich panels and glass elements, which creates the open and closed space in its unit itself. And also for the user, we add some balconies and some different modules for the unit. Then how the panels will look like. So we will have main glass panels and some sandwich panels which have some raw materials, right?
Because basically we're just building kind of like a shed topology with only that much of structure. So the thought was that a really, really simple plain structure will definitely be enough also for winter time. And here you have a little 360 degree around one possible unit that would have like one enclosed space and one semi-open space. But there could also be like completely open spaces or completely closed spaces. And that concludes our project for today.
Maybe just let me say one more sentence I forgot to mention before the comments are. We teach the students, of course, structural concepts, but all the projects that derive out of the class are interdisciplinary, at the verge of art, architectural design, structural design, and we finally what we want to achieve are critical, innovative, and teamwork-oriented students, communicative students. So in that sense, all the comments are welcome, not just on the structural design, but on the integration of all the concepts that lead to that project.
Follow the logic of it. So it to me seems that this 4D thing is a bit
to have fun, as you can see. Almost outpowered it.
A computer, and you put this and that is fine. And it's a feeling. I was happy to see this project. And now it is the second step on the next step to develop the same concept with soft perspective with the cloud. It's a long thing. I know it was a long thing. But I'm happy that the generation takes up these ideas and develops science. So thank you.
Meanwhile, like before our idea or proposal, it was also one from the have a Grand Imperial Forum on the Kaiser Forum on the German Platz, but it was never finished because he was then like to separate this. On the one side should be only for the Imperial family, and the other side should be for the Pope. And our idea is on the same place, like to have the both, like both for the population, individuals, and also for the governments. Like we have more interactions and more energy and more activities between.
So finding a design strategy throughout getting this structure work that you propose is taking the analysis what Ivan mentioned with the footprints of only existing meaningless buildings. We took overlaid them, ray traced them. So through this overlaying system we got a volumetric structure, which we divided then in units, because for our thought it's most important that it gets a modular structure. And then in the middle you see a rough sketch with red highlighted the infrastructure which connects all units.
Okay, now quickly about the building blocks. So basically we're working with the historical architecture of the city center. So we used the footprint, at the same time we zoomed in on the existing buildings, on the details. We tried to abstract them, so we can speak about some sort of ornamentation. We started with the box, so a simple cube. We used those abstractions of motifs of the historical buildings. We applied to individual blocks, which in the end created kind of a new building blocks for us. Then we tried to cluster those blocks, and then through a series of aggregations, we came up with some sort of a architectural language that we eventually used. And here you can see it when, with a human scale, so this is just a little piece, a chunk of the overall structure. Each unit is 5 by 5 by 5 meters. So using those building blocks, we, as I said, created aggregations, and then there we assigned different functions to each unit. So in one orientation, the unit could be a sun shading system or roof, but at the inverted direction, it could be a plaza or something entirely different, or let's say a circulation core.
In the terms of the program, we are placing all the important buildings like the parliament, city hall, or Ministry of Justice and President, like in the center, to get more interaction and more with the occupants. And then we are placing like shocks according to the system of the randomness. And as you can see, this is the programmatic where you can find all these buildings and circulation and the shops. Like I said, it's mostly randomly, like the different behaviors, like very unpredictable, like the disconnection between them.
Yeah. So the program in the end is to create this diverse city above the city, thus freeing up the beautiful historical buildings of the city center, and freeing them up for new functions for public to engage and to enjoy.
Okay, coming to the structural system, as you saw maybe on the image before, that this is somehow raised, the structure is raised. We were trying to come up with a new experimental approach, a blocking system that then can be used as a structural system. So first, we show this in a mock-up. We analyze the position of columns, and we optimize them with collaterals. Then the growth process starts to actually generate the beams. So by using these blocking algorithms of birds actually flying, we kind of use this this simulation process to generate this load-bearing structure. To actually make it then work though, there are several steps that we will show in the animation. So first it is growing, then you have a bundling to be able to actually create structure that is able to move the forest down into the ground. And then, of course, after the bundling, since you don't have, after the bundling, we try to give it some angles, some discretization to be able to work actually properly. And after discretization, of course, we need some horizontal connections. So we've raised them by proximity to each other. So every beam, the beam proximity is used to kind of create horizontal bracing in between the beams. And then you can see the structural analysis. So this is a system, we have this mesh load applied and supports. And then we as well try to optimize, take out elements. We use the Ville analysis to optimize the number of elements in the end to get as least elements as possible. And we came up with this system that has 49% of utilization. So using this mock-up system then applied on the whole structure, we actually did the same, it was the same process. So first we optimized the beam positions on the heading parts for the structure. And then let it grow, let it optimize, let it discretize and analyze it. And in the end we came up with this solution and it had a utilization of 65%.
And as a last piece of presentation, a few elevations and vendors. Strong political stance in the works, and back then was the age of fundraising of Cedric Price. So I guess we took a little bit of inspiration out of that to create something that maybe is a bit too much, but it was, I would say, on purpose.
But many of these concepts of Cedric Price also had really to do with lightweight construction.
I think what you presented here is this short version.
Very short.
Yes, there is the longer story behind this. Yeah. And how do you get from Yona Friedman to this? You should have explained it. Yes.
And then there's another point. I was thinking a lot about architecture by the inhabitant because Africa, okay, a style gets invents itself. A style is never invented by individuals, but it will be ridiculous to try to invent the gods. But this is the way that to towers inventing a style gets that. That's where the world comes. And I think that's the important. And if you look, your presentation reminds me some of the models I was doing with this Ravisa. And that's, it was based on a reality. As such that my proposal to avoid demolition, to not to express people like it happened to practice for reading news, but as the transition and doing something. And why I was speaking about style, in that time, it was impossible to explain as people like drawings and to see was going is source and sort of a city. And the second thing, what I find important is your proposition. These things is interesting if you keep the model and make city for transversal. Because a drawing is always a compromise. And when I choose my structures in real size or in 3D chopper, I got myself surprised of the difference of the drawing. And I think that a style invents itself, and this is a process which is inevitable. And I think that every dental is alive. And I got to go on the line translation as I went. You see, everyone. I'm giving all this as an example of inequality. It's simply my body itself. Welfare state of 100 million cents to cooperate. There is no central point. And that's the and I see, you see, I'm not always talking about the concept of neighborhood, of urban village, that means the peace, the cooperation with the neighbors, this communal contact. If you look this, this image, because one of the elements of the central concept. And I'm interested, if, you know, I don't know your group, but I would give them just, yes, but you start two of you, then this other part, that means your personal contribution. And that's important. So I like the variety of this thing. And individualism can be in harmony with a collective consensus. and this university. And so I thank you very much.
Thank you.
I think it is also important.
Just to make sure that we do not have lots of shadow areas, especially next to the historic facades.
And exploring the principles of megastructure, what we notice and which we like a lot, that the principle that all people are individuals. And that was the reason why people were allowed in megastructures to pick their own space to live. And what we tried to do is to carry this principle during all our work process, and just to make a smart system where we can put and locate our units whatever we like according to our needs and conditions.
We try to address a problem that the schools in Vienna have. First, most straightforward one is that the districts of Marienhof and Lombard, which are actually close to Helden, but are lacking in schools. But other developments are more troublesome, that these schools tend to separate the kids by their socioeconomic backgrounds. So kids from poorer or immigrant backgrounds don't get to learn, study, and grow up with people from Austria that are wealthier and know the language better. And and also another problem with the schools is that most of these, especially in the inner part of the city, those have been built and designed at the late 19th century, beginning of 20th century, so they cannot be adapted to newer ways of teaching. So it's hard to incorporate a whole school day for the kids, like Ganztag Schüler, to keep the kids there for the entire day. It's not really possible from an architectural point of view.
So, exploring the initial system, we try to be as accurate as possible. We try to investigate the composition, the axis of motion, the collaboration of the buildings and objects such as the statue and building which is looked on. And we try to see the initial principles of the already existing space. And also using this system, just we explore some different types of the megastructure system, and we took this as a module, and one of our principles was just to make a smart system where the system reacts on the loads, and we try to calculate the different section types according to the load which the system can.
So we have units with length of 30 by 30 meters, and the sections, cross sections, vary from 1 meter to 6 meters. Utilization up to
70%. So, with the idea of exchanging and creating an integrated system of usable spaces and green spaces, and trying to represent this idea of socially inclusively mixing up system, this meandering kind of circulation moving between all of these different elements to bring them into one homogeneous system. Collectively, like so, representative of this sort of complex diagram, which kind of shows all of these things mix up, whether it isn't one thing or another, this kind of dynamic interchange between built elements and the green spaces and how they react depends on this meandering structure.
This section just demonstrates the kind of units, how it can be looked like different units which are connected with each other, creating big spaces or small spaces, and this is just the whole space which just work in collaboration with all these units.
And coming back to the green spaces, we also want to illustrate how these green areas might be integrated within the structure. And it was also one approach of ours to integrate the outgarden, as you see on the bottom left, how the garden might grow inside the structure models. And this is a collage which will illustrate that this space underneath could also be used as usable space like playgrounds or fairgrounds, which is especially inviting for children.
was glad to see this because it reminds me that buildings I was building this December in China. And it is, and I like this presentation. You see that in all this new project, but for me it was fundamental, and in your projects, all of them, it included the improvisation. You don't start on the paper, and I made it now in several places in real scale with real people, and it works. Improvisation works. It is the basic intellectual process. Intelligence starts with improvisation. And I like to see this in Paris and in Marseille. There were primary schools who made the experiment. Children liked it and did it. And one of the prizes I am proud to see, it's a little medal made by school children, 8 years old, for my proposal. It is the generation for whom this thought exists. And as I told you, your three projects show how a style, an attitude, a concept tries to invent itself. I could do something. It happened so that I gave an initial step. Some of you mentioned Cedric Price. Indeed, Cedric Price met me and before the Fan Palace. And we were talking about it. And that's the important thing, that with everybody it takes a different shape. And this is improvisation. Improvisation is highly individualist. You cannot improvise as a large group. And I was very happy with this three presentation. It gives me a reassurance that a new generation tries to invent it, and it will enrich, and my old proposals are old fashioned because the new forms are, and this makes me happy.
Thank you, guests, for coming. Thank you for your first year students. Thank you for your project. As you heard, they are all great. And thank you for your comments. But especially, special thank you to Yona Friedman. So, you said you got a present from the students to your birthday, but what you really got by your comments, you got real fruitful presents for our future. Thank you.
Could be presented in art. school official in 60, students came to me and I was talking to them. But you know the official schools, they were against. Can you imagine that in the 50s, the idea of mobile architecture I was proposing for my PhD thesis, and it was refused. And this is what happens. Nobody can foresee what comes out of an idea. And I understand that for the academy at that time, this seemed impossible, improvisation and architecture. How can it be? How can it be that architecture is not mobile, that it's not built for eternity? And it slowly became accepted, and now there is something more than accepted, and that's what I write here. It is understood, and that's a good because mainstream architecture very often accepts the idea, only the formal parts. But with the students' presentation, now I felt that it is understood, interpreted in their own way, and I think that this is really the way of developing it. All time when students show me ideas based on my own ideas, I have always a surprise and a happy surprise to see, oh, it could be even so much developed. And I think so. And this, I don't know, in Japan, in China, in these things, everywhere. And you see, I was making a very small thing in Venice, and I had asked the organizers, besides what I had to do officially, have hula hoops. And they had a bag of hula hoops waiting there. And then children started to come on, it was in a public place, and started to play. And some students explain them how they can deal with it. And they start to pass by came, and they built up big structures. And they built up in 4 different places in Venice. And they were happy with it. They were going in a procession through the city with the objects they had built. And that shows that people like to build, like to see. It's a game for them, and it's possible. And in Paris, I made it in a public street in central Paris for a particular occasion. The Minister of Culture came and, okay, I made it in the Pompidou Center again with the passerby in the space before the Pompidou Center and in the entrance. They started to build. And in all these cases, the interesting is that we filled it. That means it is not simply the result, but how it came on, how people did it, how did they react. And that's important. I think improvisation in architecture opens the field for, if you want architecture for art, a people's architecture. I was repeating it in the meantime in several places. And people are interested and try always some details or the one. They invent their own solutions. And this is why I am speaking so much, that there is something that invents itself. It's not me, the inventor. I had the chance to give a starting kick, but now the thing invents itself. And I am not sure in my age that I will see how it develops, but I am full of optimism. And you all, you increase my optimism. This is why I say.